Another day in treasuries, another range-bound trade. We have yet to see a real big spike. We've seen yields hover in about an 8 basis point range going back to September 10th, and it looks to me like we're going to continue to see that despite the fact that we've got, you know, questions about the economy, we've got economic data coming out, we've got central bankers speaking, we've got risks to where we go with this election. All of that is out there, but yet the treasury market continues to just kind of trade sideways. And we're looking at a huge stock sell-off. We're looking at a huge commodity sell-off. We're looking at a huge dollar rally. And the market, the treasury market just seems unaffected by it all. And it has been for quite some time. This isn't something new. So we continue to see that range trade with very little risk of a breakout, at least today from where we sit. Certainly there will become a catalyst event, or there will be a moment in the future where we do see a breakout. But right now, we continue to trade the range and hover ever so quietly while other markets around us dance and show explosions of volatility. Market volatility in the bond market, well, it's near year-to-date lows, as you would expect. There doesn't seem to be any real risk even creeping in about the election. We talked several weeks, even months ago, about how volatility should be firming up in the back months, given the uncertainty of the election, given the uncertainty of the outcome and the differences in the candidates. And we just haven't seen that. It's very rare, but the bond market is what the bond market is, and it will continue to trade very stoically, watching and waiting, not overreacting, but responding to when things happen, whether it be a Fed speaker, whether it be a piece of economic data. That will continue, and volatility likewise will continue lower. Now, one thing that may change that this week is we get Powell, the Fed chairman, speaking not once, not twice, but three times, and possibly could be a market mover here. Recall last week we had the Fed FOMC meeting. Obviously, it shook things up a little bit. Maybe wasn't quite as dovish as expectations had hoped. Mr. Powell will be speaking to the House and Senate Financing Committees on Tuesday and Thursday about the CARES Act. That is a scheduled testimony. He will also be speaking to the House Select Committee about COVID. So there could be some questions and there could be some uncertainties or some questions that are left unanswered. That could give the market something to dance around. But at this point, it seems volatility should be firmer given all that we know around us. So vol is very cheap in bond space. It's cheap pretty much everywhere, given what central banks around the globe have done, injecting and intervening in the markets. But certainly in the bond market, it is as low as it has been in a long, long time. So another day, another range-bound trade. But look out, Mr. Powell speaking on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday.